Okay, day 40, Farming Simulator 19 on PS4. Of course, we're at Ravenport. And it's still nighttime. So we're going to find some missions to do and make some money. Nice thing about this game is you never have to sleep. Unless you want to. So my loading screen is frozen. What happened? My disk stopped spinning. There we go. Start. Let's go to contracts right away. See if there's... Let's do harvesting. That's just the easiest thing to do at night. I don't think there's anything cultivating. We could cultivate, I guess. Transport missions. Dairy station. Cement factory. Let's do this one. This one's easy. Cement factory's down by the restaurant. Construction site's not too far away. It's 6 pallets, I think, again. But, let's do it anyway. Let's go ahead. I'm dragging on the ground. Yeah, lift it up. There we go. Kind of a long drive down to the concrete plant from here, but what are you gonna do? If you don't like boredom, you're not gonna like Farming Simulator. It's just part of the game. Speaking of that, the next game, after this game, the next game to be on this channel will be Wreckfest. Wreckfest had a release date of, originally it was November 20th, I think it was the same day as this game. November 20th, 2018. Maybe it was a week after. I forget. Anyway, so then in October, the developer, the publisher, pushed the game back to March 31st, 2019. And now, every place that I look, it just says 2019 for the release date for PS4. So, I don't know if March 31st got scrapped. Just go up the hill here, I guess. So I don't know if March 31st got scrapped. And they're going to push it back again, but without a date given. Not really sure. I haven't really researched it too much. I'm sure if I search YouTube, or somebody's probably following this. Although there's a ton of people playing Wreckfest on PC or Steam. And that's been available since June. I think there's sometime in the summer of last year. So I'm sure there's a lot of people that are I don't know how big of a seller it's going to be for PS4. I guess we'll find out. And Xbox too, obviously. Xbox One is available for Xbox. Will be. That moon is bright in this game. You can look up at the tower here. Stop and look. That's a bad angle. Have you seen when we're coming down the hill? Yep, full moon. You can see the moonlight off the... It's like a glare, like a bald man's head off the top of that tower. Can you see that? We want to go to the yellow dot on the map. As soon as we get a little bit more daylight, we're going to start cutting down trees again. Up by 326. Looks like something dragging. Got a flat tire. Can you hear that, or is it just in my headphones? Must have been something on the... That went away. Must have been something on the surface of a shop there in the parking lot. Was on the property of the shop. Whatever this kind of asphalt is made out of, it must be more rough. Makes the tires louder. Sounds like a bad wheel bearing or grinding salt or something. Anyway, so let's stab this one. It's not on there very well, but okay. Need to go to the construction site, that's right. This hill always slows us down. Makes me want to put a turbo or something on this thing. 3 miles an hour. Is this thing LP? Sounds like LP or gas. I don't know how you can tell, not that it matters. I mean, fuel is fuel. As far as video games go, I mean, in real life, it makes a difference. You want to put LP in your diesel truck or diesel in your gasoline truck. Of course, what have you. I remember when I was in high school, there was a big shop class, and there was this student that was in the grade below me, and they had whatever the shop class was called, the freshman, or not freshman, sophomore. And his car wouldn't run, so he brings it into the shop, and him and his friends were not experts at all. Of course. And I don't even remember what kind of car that was. They spray, like 2 years later, they spray painted it with, well, spray paint, but yeah, so yeah, they painted it with spray paint because it was getting rusty. It was blue and they painted it black. But anyway, it wouldn't run at all, and there was a diesel pump. For some reason, the bus garage was near the shop. So outside the shop, between the shop and the bus garage, was this diesel pump, or the, I guess it was the buses would fill up with fuel at the beginning or end of the day. And so they go up there and they pump a fuel can full of, you know, 3 gallons or whatever it was of diesel fuel. I'm like, well, either they didn't know it was diesel fuel or they knew it after they already put it in, but hard to say that they weren't that smart, but anyways, they put 3 gallons of diesel fuel in it, started up the car, and it ran. Didn't run good, but it ran. Gasoline car, and it ran on diesel fuel. So I don't know what the... I never found out what the problem with the car was. Why it ran on diesel fuel, but it wouldn't run on gasoline. They did get it fixed, because the kid broke the car for another 2 years. I don't know if the timing was off. I don't know. I don't even remember what kind of car it was, what make of car it was. I think it was a Chevrolet, but maybe not. Chevy Citation, maybe? It wasn't much of a car, but then he had a... the first kid at our school. This was in the early 90s, mind you. First kid at our school that had a... car stereo that had subwoofers. I don't think anybody knew what subwoofers were before that day, or before that kid had he had an 18-inch subwoofer in his car. It was loud, but he didn't have it. I don't think he had it in the right type of enclosure, right size of enclosure, that is. And I don't remember what kind of amplifier he had. It wasn't all, it was just kind of thrown together. And then at that point it became a pissing match or contest for all the people that had, all the guys especially that had their own car, which I had my own car. It was a piece of junk too. My first car was a 1980 Datsun 210. Which is the equivalent of the Nissan Sunny, which they sold in Europe and Japan, I think. Not a B210, a B210 is a truck. Just a Datsun 210. 1980. And I drove that car for like 6 months. But I never had a car stereo. My third car. This car I drove for like 6 months, from like November until April. I'm trying to think if I had a subwoofer in my second car. I must have. Yeah, I did, because my second car was the 86 Renault Alliance, or Renault Alliance, which is like the AMC Renault partnership. So it was was it an AMC engine and a Renault body, or was it a Renault engine and an AMC body? I don't remember. Pretty bad car. I mean, I shouldn't say bad, it's just whatever. It's my second car I ever owned, less than a year after I got my license. That's how bad my first car was. My dad hated that car. He's that Datsun. It ran good. It had a 5-speed manual transmission, and it had a 1.6 liter or 1.4 liter, I don't remember. Small 4-cylinder engine that ran like a top. But the damn thing was so rusty. It was so rusty, like the frame. It had a unibody, obviously, but the frame was like, my dad said if I would have wrecked that thing, it would have folded up like, you know, would have folded up like an accordion, and I wouldn't have made it. He hated me driving that thing. And it was so rusty on the body panels, it was like mostly rust. Like, it was a yellow car, but most of the color was like yellow and brown, it was like a rotten banana. And then the can lift up the carpet on the driver's side, or on the, I'm sorry, the passenger side floorboard, you can lift up the carpet, because it was like, ripped, and you can see the road. I'm probably repeating myself, because I've said this in other videos, but, and then there was no key. Something happened to the ignition. This is before I even bought it. It sat in someone's tobacco shed for many years before I bought it for $50. Anyway, so it sat in their tobacco shed for I don't know how many years. And, I bought it, put a muffler on it. Actually, the owner, he put a muffler on it for me. He was a friend of my dad's. And he put a muffler on it, and I gave him the money, and off we went. And, what was I talking about? Oh, yeah, it didn't have any keys. So the original, the ignition was still in the steering column, but that was cut out, or the wires were cut, and then, some type of switch was installed like underneath the steering column that was like hanging down. I said this story already, I know I did. And so it just had like a slot so you could stick anything in there and turn the switch or turn the, yeah, the switch. And so I just had a little stubby screwdriver, just stuck the screwdriver in there, turn the switch, and it would start the car. So like an ignition bypass, I think you could do that. And my car got, it's like a community car. Girls would take my car in lunch hour and drive it without asking permission or anything. Of course, I was like, oh, whatever. I didn't even really tell anybody that's how to start the car. I have a twin sister, maybe she told. All you gotta tell is one person, everybody finds out. But nobody else took my car, just these hot chicks, girls that were attractive, get away with murder. It must have happened 5 or 6 times. And I stayed on campus for lunch, so I didn't really notice. And someone's like, hey, we went to, wherever, Subway or something for lunch. 3 girls had your car. No way. First time I heard of it. There's no way. Of course, they probably knew I wouldn't say anything. One of the girls had she had her own car. Her dad owned a car dealership. Used car dealership, / junkyard. Or end of junkyard, I should say. She always had a car. I don't know why they took mine, but whatever. When you're in high school, everything's funny. But all those stories have nothing to do with Farming Simulator. Got off on a tangent there. But, you know, there's nothing to talk about sometimes. What do you talk about when you're transporting pallets? At night, when there's nothing to see. Should get one of my friends. I told him he should just, told him years ago he should write a book about some of the stories he has in his life. They're not all bad, they're just some of the stuff. I kind of play it safe. I like to go to work and go home and that's it. Especially now that I'm middle-aged, but he's not that way, and he's never been that way. He's probably a little bit that way more now that he's got kids to take care of and stuff, but when he was younger, he didn't have kids. Of course, he wouldn't have to write a book anymore. He just talk into his phone. Everybody has a TV studio in their pocket. Tell his stories on camera. And the whole world can see him. I turned up the resolution on this video because I don't even know how it looks. I turned up the resolution on this video because I had it turned down to 720p because I thought it would be broadcast better that way, or it would be less grainy or transmit better, but maybe that was a mistake. I turned it up to 1080p just before I started this broadcast, and I guess it looks better. I guess we'll have to see on the replay. Don't have anybody to verify it. It looks better on my TV anyway while I'm playing. I see more detail. Especially that map in the bottom left. Of course, I'm sitting in a different chair than I usually do, so it's been closer to the TV. That helps, obviously. But, see the map, the details on the map a little better than some of the roads that hardly showed up in the old, at the old resolution, 720. Yep, halfway home. I don't know how anybody can pick up pallets from this view here. I guess you can kind of see the forks, but how do you tell when you can't? I can't see the forks at all. I guess I know where they're at because they're behind these, what do you call these, not the outrigger, that's the bottom, the masts, in front of these two masts, but it's hard to judge how far they are off the ground or what angle from where I'm sitting. Let's try it anyway. I know it's gotta be lower. Yep. What have I been doing on YouTube? What have I been watching on YouTube? I've been watching Z Reviews. I just started watching that less than a week ago. That's pretty good. I forget the guy's name. He's got a different... It starts with Z. Is it Xanu? Not Xanu. That's like a Scientology thing. I forget his name. If you look up Z Reviews, he does audio reviews, and he does audio reviews for headphones, speakers, subwoofers, amplifiers. I don't know if he does preamps, like DACs, digital audio converters, CD players, turntables maybe? Oh, I haven't seen any of the turntables. Receivers. Well, anything of that nature. I mean, he does normal stuff. When I say normal, I mean stuff that working people can afford. Not speakers that Henry Rollins has in his house. If you don't know, Henry Rollins has a pair of... He probably has more than one pair, but he has a pair of Wilson audio speakers that weigh... How much do they weigh? 600 pounds a piece or something like that? If you look up Wilson audio on the internet, you'll see the products that they sell. And his speakers are like $60,000 a pair. And then he listens to records. I guess records can sound good, but being a CD guy, still infatuated with CDs. Even after, I mean, MP3s are pretty cool. Almost 20 years ago, MP3s were cool because they're ultra portable. But still like CDs for some reason. I don't know why. And I lost track of all the CDs that I own. I have two big totes full of them. And I'm trying to figure out some way to organize them, but I don't have anything to really play them on. I have a Bose Wave radio. That's it. I'd like to have some kind of stereo system at home here. But it's not going to be down the road. So anyways, I've owned LPs and records in the past. There was a time, this was almost 20 years ago too, when I went to a couple Pearl Jam concerts. And I was in their fan club at the time. And when you're, this might still be the case, I don't know. When you're in their fan club, they send you, at Christmas time, they send you a vinyl record of whatever, one or two songs or whatever that's just songs just for the fan club. So it's like not going to be on any album or anything like that. Our soundtrack is just songs just for the fan club members. So I joined their fan club to get special tickets for some concerts. And then I didn't even know that they sent out music. And I it was like in November, and I get this package in the mail, and it's this record. I'm like, what the hell? So I didn't have nothing to play it on, so I went out and bought a. My roommate at the time, because I was 20-something years old. My roommate at the time had a stereo, Pioneer speakers and Pioneer receiver and stuff like that, and five disc changer. So I just went out, I forget what brand it was. Anyway, bought a $100, $150 turntable. Just so I could listen to this one record that I had. Well, then the next year I got another record and another record the next year. Those were the only vinyl that I ever had that I can think of. And now I want to get some vinyl just to put them on my wall in the basement. Not to play, just to display like albums that I think are really cool still. Like there's got to be like maybe 50 or 75 albums that I have listened to or own that I love every song. So I want to get some of those on LP or vinyl and then just hang those on my wall in my basement. And so I don't know why. I've seen it just looks cool. Like I've watched some YouTube videos of some people that just use LPs as wall art, I guess. And Joey Diaz has some, I don't think they're albums, I think they're just like screen prints or something of albums that he likes. So if you ever watch The Church of What's Happening Now on YouTube, you see that he has screen prints or some kind of printout of, let's see, Def Leppard, High and Dry. And what's the other ones? He's got two or three more. I'd have to go watch again and see what those are. There's one of them, Black Sabbath. I forget. But anyway, it looks cool just to have a... Well, I think it looks cool. My wife wouldn't agree with that. So, but it looks, if you have a man cave or a, anywhere you listen to music. So I have a friend that listens to music out in his garage, and watches TV out there too. And he's got some posters of Pink Floyd and, I forget the other one, Led Zeppelin maybe. Or Jimi Hendrix. He's got those posters in his on his wall in his garage, but albums would look good up there too. So how many, you got one pallet left to go? If I'm not mistaken. Maybe two. I lost track. Busy slapping my jaw. We still got lots of, well, it's 1 a.m., 1:05, so the sun comes up at 5:30 or something like that. So we can probably do, after this mission, we can probably do, depends on what kind of missions we do, but two or three more missions, and then the sun will be up. So can't wait for that. Trying to, back to the LP thing, I was trying to think of some albums that I like all the songs, and then the album art looks cool too. And I guess it's not really an LP, but Alice in Chains' Jar of Flies, I want to get that on the LP or vinyl, because I like that cover. I don't know, that CD, ever since the week it came out, I've listened to it regularly, not every week or every month or anything, but all the songs on that CD never get old. And so I thought about putting that up in my basement. Okay, so we got one more pallet. They just have blank walls down here. So that was one album that I wanted to display. Soundgarden, Bad Motorfinger. That was the first Soundgarden album that I ever heard of. That's the album that introduced me to Soundgarden. And back in the day, I don't know if you remember Columbia House or BMG Music Club. They found out I was a member of that for many years. Like 5 years during my adolescence, and that was one way that I got introduced to a bunch of new music. That's what introduced me to Soundgarden, was like every month they'd have a feature, so you'd pick a genre of music that you like. And of course I liked heavy metal or hardened rock or whatever you call it, and then they would pick out an album for that month, and then you would have to, every month they'd send you a small booklet that had albums, not all the albums available, but a lot of the albums available, and then they had new ones in there too. And so, and then along with that they'd send you like a postcard. Say the album of the month is this, you know, and they have it featured in the little booklet, and so you could read about it and see what the album cover looked like and read about the artist and blah blah blah. And then if you wanted to, it was kind of backwards, if you wanted to buy that album for that month, then you did nothing. If you didn't want it, then you had to send the postcard into them by a certain date. And there was a lot of times where I would send them in late or forget to send them in at all, and then I'd end up with a CD and have to pay $20 or whatever it was for a CD that I was expecting or wasn't expecting, usually not expecting. But there was some times that it worked out anyway because I was an artist I wasn't familiar with, but they sounded good. And Soundgarden was one of those that I'd never heard of, because in 1990 I was still listening to Skid Row, Whitesnake, all the hair metal stuff, Pantera, Sepultura, Megadeth, bands like that. And so I wasn't really familiar with, never heard of Soundgarden, but they sounded good. So, I don't know if that was my first, I would say maybe them or Alice in Chains was my first quote-unquote grunge album that I ever owned or listened to. I don't know if all those are in there. Did it say Contract Finished? Or Transport Finished? Nope. So we have some rearrange. This happened last time. These stupid pallets that hang out at all. Must be the ones in the back here. Stupid table saw out of the way. I don't think we can bump it. Nope. It's cemented into the ground. It's one way to not get it, have it not be stolen. That must still be a problem. People stealing generators and stuff from construction sites. There was a large theft in our area. It's probably been a year ago now, where someone stole like a bunch of copper pipe. Maybe it wasn't pipe, maybe it was copper wire. I don't know. They stole like $10,000 worth of copper. From a construction site. But damn it. Do I have to put these in here the other way? Just a little bit. Should be in there though. Can they not touch the yellow at all? 83%. What the hell? We went from 67 to 83. This is sticking out here. Oh, nudge it a little bit here. There, is that gonna do it? Damn it. Check the back side. Must be something sticking out of the back. That's all in here. I don't understand. If it was done, it would say transport finished. I feel like Austin Powers. There we go. Transport finished. What the heck? That took long enough. So let's... Wait a minute. Go here and collect $2,148. Wait a minute. This is going to put us over 180. So let's go back. Collect this. That's a wrap. We got no speed bonus. Sometimes you get a speed bonus with these missions, but you got nothing. So, that's gonna be it for today, I think. I'm just gonna leave this here. What the hell? So, we got our mission done. Let's go ahead and save this quick. So, thanks for watching. I don't know how many people are out there watching. One or two. And if you like this video, you know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff. And we'll see you in the next video. Have a good night, everybody. Come on.